等那个，等我别的那些筹备工作做好以后，慢慢的就被事情就多了。你现在，
什么臭逼的工作啊？
我本身也，反正出来，如果要是只说就这样的，过这样的日子就没什么意思了。因为本身这样的逃亡啊什么的，都只是就希望能够那样的做一点有益于那样的促进中国那个民主化的那个工作。
好，那你现在就打开这个YouTube 那个片段，我想你都没有看过吗？那这个 YouTube 的片段。
Good evening, I'm Peter Mansbridge. Tonight, a special extended edition of Sunday Report. Extended because of the extraordinary number of major news developments around the world. We'll get to Iran and the Soviet Union a bit later, but first to China and Beijing, where it's already Monday morning. The city is in shock. The military is in control. But it is control won at a terrifying price. Their merciless storming of Tiananmen Square has cost many lives. There is no official count of the dead and wounded, but hospital sources in Beijing say at least 1,400 people were killed. They say 10,000 were hurt, and the worst of it may not be over yet. The army had a statement a few hours ago, a frightening statement given all that has gone on. It said the assault on Tiananmen Square was, quote, just an initial victory. And it said there was still a long fight ahead against, and again we quote, the dregs of society. On this broadcast, we're going to bring you right up to date. But to do that, you really have to go back first, back 24 hours. That's when the People's Liberation Army was set loose, when the rebellion for democracy was literally crushed. The Chinese government made it impossible to get videotape out of the country until today. But now the pictures are out, and Tom Kennedy takes us through them from the Chinese capital.
At dawn this morning, the streets of Beijing looked and sounded like a war zone. Beijing residents were still challenging the might of the People's Liberation Army, but it was a hopeless cause. They were being shot, and everywhere, evidence of the carnage. Hospitals all over the city were flooded with the wounded and the dead. Doctors contacted by reporters were exhausted and were saying simply they had no idea how many were killed and they were too busy to talk. In Tiananmen Square, lines of tanks and soldiers were a clear sign that the military had total control of the center of the city. Periodic shooting demonstrated that they were not going to move away and that any further resistance would cost people their lives. In all, the army put on a vicious show of brute force. Midnight Beijing time, Saturday night, it began its attack. It moved towards the square from both the east and the west. Millions of city residents were out in the streets. In some places, they succeeded in stopping all columns, shouting, begging soldiers to go no further. The People's Army, someone shouted, must not attack the people. But it was only a temporary respite. Tanks, armored personnel carriers, and thousands of soldiers blasted their way through. They were under orders from Supreme Leader Deng Xiaoping, who official sources say gave the order to attack from a hospital bed where he is being treated for cancer. 1 million Chinese, Deng said, can be considered a small number. So soldiers began shooting anyone who got in their way. On the major routes into the city center, people fought back with the only weapons available to them, stones, bricks, Molotov cocktails. Dozens of armored vehicles were set on fire. Soldiers who became separated from the main column faced mob justice. Square, the massacre began.
So this is the first time you've seen it in 18 years, a report from CBC, what do you think?
杜晴, 就是你18年来 第一次看到CBC这个报道 当时的情况, 你有什么想法? 六四之前的那个十天前就已经失去了自由，所以这些现场的那一些资料，我们是现场我们是没有亲身的经历过，但是每一次呢，看到这些镜头啊，那都是那样的心啊，好像是那样的紧紧。这一次是那个CBC，我看CBC的那一些。 所收集的那些资料的是第一次，确实是他们那做得很不错。You
seem very upset. 你我看你好像很不舒服。对，确实。
但可惜，就是说，一直到现在18年以后的今天，中国大陆还有很多老百姓啊，都不知道当年发生了什么事情。这是其实是可以说是一种更大的悲哀。So
quite upset that the many Chinese people don't really know what happened. What do you plan to do? 你说你不知，你相信很多。 中国人都不知道当时的情况是怎么样，你打算怎么做呢？你看到这个，so you've seen this YouTube video, what are you gonna do? 你看到这个 YouTube 的录影，你有什么想法，有什么打算做？我希望不单纯是这个六四的那一些影像资料，以及那一些就是说。 现在发生在那样的大陆的那一些，中国大陆的那一些，侵犯人权的那一些令人发指的事件呢，都因为在中国幅员辽阔，所以往往一般都是只是知道那样的局部的那样的情况。 所以很多是可以说是一种出口转内销，是本身是发生在大陆的那样的情况，但是往往好多第一时间都是先传到那样的海外，然后再从海外传进去。
这样的，你看这一次的那个。
So you mentioned that it's like export turning in import. 出口转来销，就是 things that happen in China. It's people don't know about it, and they have to learn it from outside world. 中国国内发生的事，你要从外国外国的新闻才知道。
是啊，所以说你一看中国大陆的那样的民众的那一种知情权，以及那样的就是说新闻自由的那一个权利，都等等这方面，还不用说那样的上升到更加的那样的权，那样的深度去维护那样的相关的那一些人权吧。所以你仅仅是这些知情权都还有待于大家去努力的促进。所以我想先从这些方面那样的入手，以及就是说配合那一些维权人士的那一些行动啊，促使那样的把这一个人权的那一种中国人的那个人权的那个空间呢、啊，逐渐的那样扩大，这是一个方面了。另外还有一些别的那样的做法，
So the Chinese people's right to know the 中国人的知情权，你这个方面你怎么有什么想法 ？What do you think about the Chinese people's right to know and how are you going to remedy that？你有什么想法去将它改正呢？
现在的高科技，通信渠道使通信渠道更加畅通，这个是高科技给我们带来的方便。但是我们必须看到的呢，就是说，中共他们采取的那一些封锁的那一种措施啊，给这一些大陆的那一些民众知情的那一个空间呢、使他们的空间大打折扣，这是一个我们必须看到的一个现实问题。但是我们又可以那样的乐观的地方呢，你想，我们现在这样的高科技，与那个以前没有那样的 internet， 没有那样的录像设备啊，以及那样的甚至那样的录音设备，以前的那个最原始的那一种状态，最传统的那样的传统的时候，你看，我们举个例子，那个100年前孙中山。先生他们那领导的那样的辛亥革命的时候，推翻那样的满清帝国，他们用的是那一种，可以说是，很传统的那个方法，传递那样的信息，让那样的民众逐渐的那样的觉醒。所以你看，我们现在100年以后。我们要比他们要有利的条件多得多，所以只要是大家能够主观上有那一种决心突破那样的中共的那一些新闻封锁，我相信这个路是会越走越宽的。